thanks a lot, man. We appreciate that. Wow. Monday, tomorrow, Wednesday, give the toys
away.
Wednesday's
a toy giveaway. Yes, that's the big day.
Wow, this has sure snuck up on us here, I tell you. We are in the beautiful showroom at Treasure Coast Lexus, and it's a December to remember.
Yes, with the big red bows.
Are you hearing that echo? Echo. Anyway, we've got a great group of students here today. Lincoln Park Academy Orchestra under the direction of Laura Hopkins. They're going to start our show out with some Christmas cheer. Take it away. All these students perform. We've got a full orchestra now.
Yes.
And wow.
This will be on the school district's YouTube channel, so you'll be able to see the students in their full black, beautiful, black dresses and tuxedos.
Black tuxedos for the guys.
Formal wear. And yet, for those on the radio, this is quite a formal occasion.
And what a formal showroom this is as well.
It is.
We've got the spiral staircase going here. Come on now.
Well, and we want to welcome the General Manager, Jerry Mariorossi, from Treasure Coast Lexus.
Thank you very much, Carol, and so happy to have everyone here. They sound fabulous, don't they?
Yeah,
they do.
Amazing.
And the acoustics in here is just wonderful. You have a concert band.
We do. We do, just for this occasion. So we're couldn't be happier. It's December to remember, and glad you could all come and help celebrate it with us. So.
Now, when we hear December to Remember, I mean, obviously, we've been hearing it for a few weeks now.
Yes. December to Remember, has been going on for over 20 years now, and each December, Lexus has their biggest, best promotion / sale of the year, and it's a great time to come and look at a new Lexus or a certified pre-owned Lexus, and it's our end of the year blowout, if we can call it that. And it's so funny because so many of our guests are conditioned to wait until December to come and actually purchase a car. They know this is the time to do it. So it's a great time of year for us. We're extremely busy, along with, you know, all of our personal commitments for the holidays. So it's a great time of year. Very hectic. It goes by in the blink of an eye.
What are most people looking at? What's the most popular?
You know, our most popular model is our RX. That's our SUV, and by far it's been our most popular model for 15 years. Yeah. So, but sedans, the ES is very popular, and then the larger models, we have the GX and the LX, and they're all just fabulous vehicles. We're very fortunate to work with Lexus, and they just make great cars. So.
And I love the bows.
Red bow.
And that's a good. Every year we ask about that bow. We ask, what does it take for me to buy the car and get the bow?
That can be worked out. Everything is negotiable.
And you know that phrase, "A December to Remember," that is the catchphrase of the century. I mean, I say it all the time.
It's brilliant, you know. And again, so fortunate working with Lexus. They're just really smart people,
mm-hmm.
and they coined that way back when, and it's kind of become, it's in the lexicon now, you know, December to Remember. People know what that means. Done a great job of branding it. And just a great event. We look forward to it every year, and we're having a great time this year. The only negative to the whole thing is if you take a look out on our lot, we don't have a lot of cars.
Mm.
We have been selling them faster than they're coming in. So we've encouraged everybody, all of our guests, to don't wait. A lot of people like to procrastinate, you know, say, well, I'll do it after, you know, Christmas, after the holidays, that last week I'll come in just before it ends. And unfortunately, we may not have, you know, the color that you want or the equipment that you want, you know, if you wait. So we're encouraging everybody to do it sooner versus later.
You know, I'm sure the commercial, I mean, there's some brilliant marketing. I mean, those commercials with the family looking outside on Christmas morning, and there's a Lexus there with a bow on it. It doesn't get much better than that.
And the ones they're doing this year with, you know, with the little kids, and then, you know, bring out the inner child,
mm-hmm.
and those are pretty neat.
Yeah.
They do a great job.
And we certainly thank Lexus and Toyota for sponsoring the Christmas kids every year, hosting us. You know, you were involved in several other charities and charitable organizations and events during the week.
Yes, that's, you know, that's Mr. Woods and Amber. They are so involved in the community, and we take a lot of pride in that, you know, and it's a great organization to work for because they do believe in being a part of this community, giving back, and you know, a lot of people say that, but they really walk that walk, and you know, Big Brothers and Big Sisters, Castle, we're involved in, and really involved, and we use this facility, you know, we kind of have an open door policy, so if somebody's having a fundraiser, we are booked up here most weeks, so.
We've all been to the Chamber of Commerce dinner here. There's just an industry, really? Yes.
Mm-hmm. I've been to many events here where this showroom becomes an event, one of the nicer events spaces on the Treasure Coast, to be honest with you.
I said we should have weddings here.
You better believe
it. Oh,
a
staircase, sure.
It is a beautiful facility, and we're proud to and happy to share it. We could be happy that you guys are here today.
Well, certainly, thank you. And we want to thank also the Lincoln Park Academy Orchestra.
Yeah, fabulous.
And if you may have another musical production for us.
Sure.
Please.
Thank you.
beautiful. And Laura, if you would step up to that microphone for us, I understand that we probably missed, we've missed one, that mic right there. You can use that one. Now, I know that we've probably missed one concert already, but there are more, and then just tilt it down just a little bit for you. There you go.
Yes, we've already had our orchestra concert.
Mm-hmm.
We're playing again tomorrow night at Dyer Chevrolet for a Fort Pierce Chamber of Commerce event at 5 to 7 p.m.
Okay.
And then there are some choir, there's a choir concert coming up this Thursday at 6:30 p.m. And then if our band director would like to come up and talk about our upcoming band concerts, Lincoln Park Academy has a lot of performing arts at our school.
Yes, Matthew Corral, who's the middle school band director.
Hello. Hey there. Thank you. We had a fantastic orchestra concert last week, so I want to thank Ms. Hopkins again for her great work this year joining us. Next week, after our chorus concert this Thursday, we do have a middle school band concert on Monday night at 6:30 p.m. and a high school band concert on Tuesday night at 6:30 p.m. And we're so proud of all of our students. We would love for the community to be involved.
Well, they're both at the school?
Yes, all of them are held at the Lincoln Park Academy Auditorium.
And an orchestra is quite a tradition at Lincoln Park. So you begin in middle school and bring everybody up on through high school.
Right. Yes, we begin in middle school. We have a beginning sixth grade orchestra and band and chorus, and then they progress throughout their high school career and hopefully beyond from there. As many colleges will pay to have musicians in their orchestras, choirs, and bands, even if you're not majoring in music. Even where I went to college in northern Wisconsin, I had several friends who were not music majors, and they had a lot of scholarship money available for the orchestra members.
How important is music as in relation to the other subjects like math?
Well, it's very important. It's an integral part. They've done several research projects on and research extensive on brain research and how it works to relate everything and the music. It makes the connections that then go to spatial reasoning and other aspects of their educational and math. So if you're good at music, you're usually good at the other subjects as well. So it's very important, and it's really nice that in the Fort Pierce area we have a lot of music going on in our school district.
And actually, it was great to hear that there is scholarship money available at the college level.
I even got one from Menards, which is kind of a Wisconsin equivalent of Home Depot. They have a race car, Menards does, a NASCAR. But I got a scholarship from Menards way back when.
That is great. Okay, well, that's good to hear. It's not just athletics. It's music
right.
as well. Mm-hmm. And we'll hear more from the Lincoln Park Academy Orchestra. Now, you mentioned the staircase. Greg had to go up and make sure he got a picture.
I can imagine that picture,
orchestra.
Greg.
Yes. And the Christmas tree and the cars.
Mm. And, you know, and this what a beautiful show, Ron. We mentioned this, and I wanted you to kind of walk us through when a person brings their car in, say, for servicing, and I've been here before and seen this process. I mean, there are just plenty of them. There's a place for them to go and do their work if they need to use a computer or anything.
There's a business office where we have cubicles set up where they can set up their laptop, make phone calls, have a conference call if they need to, and conduct any business, you know, that they would need while they were here.
Mm-hmm.
We have three different TVs with a little variety so people can hopefully watch what they want. We also have a private theater room right over there, and so we've got multiple areas for people to be comfortable and stay entertained. We have a cafe with drinks, coffee, snacks. Mm. So we try to make the time go by.
So there's no reason for you to just drop your car off and go home and wait. You can just hang out right here.
And most people do. and we encourage that. We want it to be, you know, Lexus's philosophy has always been to treat customers like you would a guest in your own home.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of the core value of Lexus. So when somebody comes in here, we want to treat them like they were a guest in our home. So if a guest came to your home, you'd want them to be comfortable.
Right.
You'd probably offer them something to drink, mm-hmm. something to eat. And that's what we do here. So it's just a wonderful facility. And again, a great company. We couldn't be happier.
And today we've gathered a little audience here. So in addition to the coffee bar and everything else, we have a concert.
Couldn't be better, could it? Doesn't get better than that.
We can start doing the morning show.
Right in the car. Yeah, very good.
Sure. Come on down. We'd love to have you.
You know, these cars these days, I mean, they're pretty much, they're computers on wheels.
They are.
And the technology that goes into, when you make delivery of a vehicle, the person driving that car out of there, is there a process that you go through to get them acquainted with the new technology inside of these cars?
Another brilliant idea from Lexus. And 3 years ago, they started, each Lexus dealership must have a delivery / technology specialist. We have three. And so when you have purchased your vehicle, the last thing you'll do before you leave is you'll spend 30, 45 minutes to an hour with a technology specialist who will show you how to use the technology. And it's modeled after the Genius Bar at Apple.
Oh, yeah.
So,
I know it well.
You know, these folks are just very technologically savvy, but also extremely patient, because most of our guests are like me, and I'm not technologically savvy. Mm-hmm. So it's good that they know how to do it, but more importantly, they know how to show somebody like me how to use the technology in the car, because it's just loaded. So they pair your cell phone to the Bluetooth. They download your contacts for you. They show you how to use all the voice commands and take advantage of all the great features that these vehicles have.
Wow, Lexus has its own Genius Bar. I like
that.
Yeah,
our own Genius
Bar. And even after you go through the initial briefing, there are things that surprise you. Oh, it does too. You see, when the gas tank gets at below half, Greg is looking for a gas station. Me, I'm waiting until, you know, it says empty for a while, you know. But with the new car, with the new Lexus, it comes up not only low on fuel, but it will give you the addresses of the five closest gas stations.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, okay.
And you have a new NX, so you went through the delivery process. What did you think of that?
Oh, well, it was great, because, you know, you need to set up we have to set up our radio stations, first of all.
First and foremost.
Make sure we can hear the station. And the Bluetooth of how to use it, mm-hmm. and, you know, the basics. I think there are things that come up later that even, you know, you can call back in. I was convinced, I had to get used to the key fob. I was convinced I had locked myself out of my car, when, in fact, you can't.
No.
You can't. Okay. No, it will not lock if the key fob is inside.
Ooh.
That's how you know.
That's good.
And yes, that's a good point, though, because it is a lot of technology, so we invite people back in for kind of a refresher course. And it is a lot at one time, so we want them to take advantage of that. The safety features on the vehicles now are amazing. And my wife has an ES, and I was driving it the first time, and this is a confession, but I'm not very good when I switch lanes about using my signal. And so I'll, you know, go from, you know, lane to lane, and while in these cars, it has what it's called lane keep assist, which the car interprets that when I do that as I'm drifting, I'm not paying attention, or I'm dozing off. Mm-hmm. And so the seat and the steering wheel vibrate to say, hey, you know, hey, you're drifting,
wake up.
And then if you do it two or three times, which I thought was hysterical, I didn't know this until I drove the car, a warning actually comes on the dashboard with a cup of coffee, steaming coffee, saying, time to pull over. Because you obviously need a break.
Uh-huh.
And, of course, it'll let you know that if you're going over and there's a car in that area, too. It'll say, hey, back off, buddy. There's a car over here.
And it's fantastic. Now that I have a blind spot monitor, when I get in a car that doesn't have it,
I know.
I'm almost lost. Mm-hmm.
And the backup camera. That is the most useful part of all the technology. And you really get used to that, where, you know, you're backing out of a parking space. Mm-hmm. Yeah, now you can see.
And it's got what is called cross-traffic alert, which when you're backing up, if somebody were coming down the road and you didn't see them because they're not directly behind you, it actually warns you that somebody is coming down the road and could hit you if you kept backing up. Just loaded with great safety features.
All those safety features, I'm thinking your insurance is probably going to be a lot cheaper, too, with all that going on.
That hasn't happened yet.
Not yet?
You know.
No, it's coming.
We have to talk to the insurance companies.
We can hope. But certainly, let's talk with Linkin Park Academy again, or listen to Linkin Park Academy Orchestra.
Please. They're fabulous.
Warwick Hopkins, a big group of students this morning. Sugar Plum, what's the title of that song?
It's the March from the Nutcracker.
The Nutcracker.
Ah,
uh-huh.
Yes. Thank you.
There's so many people we need to thank this time of year. And first of all, our volunteers worked very hard on Saturday, shopped Friday night, worked hard on Saturday. We're almost ready with all the bags. We have 1,000 children, 415 families, so there are 415 bags, just about ready. We are picking up toys today. We heard from the Sunflower Educare Center, and they collect toys every year for the Christmas kids, so we'll pick those up and add them too. So Friday morning is the big day. Wednesday morning.
2 days from now, of course, we'll be broadcasting live from the Logistics Center right down the street here.
That's right.
And with toothpicks in our eyelids, I guess, keeping us up in here.
Mm-hmm. We certainly will.
Now, from what I gather, we're filming that as well this year? I thought we were filming. Are we filming?
Oh, okay.
Okay, all right.
We may.
All right. Yeah. And that'll be a first this year for us filming the actual giveaway, the toy giveaway itself.
Yes. Yeah. And certainly thank you to Lexus for supporting the Christmas party.
Oh, our pleasure. We couldn't be happier.
And part of the tradition for the program is favorite holiday
memory. Wow.
This is your first Christmas Kids show, so
it is.
Favorite holiday memory.
So this is a tradition.
It is.
Okay. Well, mine's pretty easy. The 30 years ago, our son was born December 15th, and So his birthday is this Friday, 30. When did that happen?
Yeah.
And, but it seems like yesterday. So that was our Christmas present 30 years ago, and that is by far our best Christmas memory, best holiday.
Now you have to try to give the proper celebration to a birthday that is that close to the holiday.
It is.
Yes.
Well, he makes sure that we're on point, we don't skip, and he doesn't lose out on it.
Well, it could be worse. It could be December
24th.
Oh. See, at least it's December 15th.
Which was actually his due date, so he was a little early. So he made up for it. Mm. He just right time. But that's our favorite.
That is a great holiday memory. And something we want to thank, we've had 20-some businesses that have hosted the Christmas Kids this year. We always start off with Longwood Regional Medical Center, and we always wrap up with St. Lucie Medical Center, which is where we will be tomorrow. And then we talk with them, and normally in the cafeteria there, and then get ready for Wednesday.
Yeah, and Wednesday morning. In the past, for some reason, it's always cold on that morning. I mean, it just works out that way. Now I don't know what the weather forecast is for tomorrow, Greg, but
cool.
I'm not. Yeah,
oh,
okay.
Cool.
So cool, not cold. And we will have folks there, Greg, at what, 6 o'clock in the morning? The lines line up starting at 6:30 or so.
And we try to let them know, if they have a number, there is a toy bag for you.
We're going to take care of you.
And the door's open at 8, so you really don't need to line up early. There is a toy bag for you if you have signed up. So.
And, of course, we love the bagels with Al Sorcella. He brings us all those good things. We have a great time.
Yes, we need to make sure. Yes. So thank you, certainly, for hosting the Christmas Kids.
Thanks for coming. We couldn't be happier. This was really, really neat. My first one, and it was better than they described.
Oh, yes, and Lincoln Park Academy has made it that way. Thank you. Certainly, if keep the Christmas Kids in your heart, we'll see you again tomorrow from St. Lucie Medical Center.